Hey. Good morning. Good morning. All right. We are going to be very blessed this morning to be in each other's company, but also blessed because the holidays always means homecoming. And so this is a great time for us. And so Dakota, thank you. Good to be here. All right.
Go and tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go and tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching o'er silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when lo, above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed our Savior's birth. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lonely manger the humble Christ was born, and God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Thank you, Dakota. And thank you, Mary, for visiting with us. And I'm sorry that your voice wasn't able to be with Dakota this morning. That was the plan. And but you come all the way from Nashville, one of the best cities in the world. True? It is true. It is true. All right. Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Grace to you, peace to you, welcome to you. It is good that we come together. Hey, good morning.
Santa Claus is coming.
Santa Claus is coming. Amen. All right. Amen. Santa Claus is coming. Jesus is coming. The UPS guy is coming. All right. All right. Very good. Well, I call your attention to announcements. Take a look at all the different things that are going on. I want to especially remind you and call attention to our Christmas Eve services. Is that tomorrow night? All right, it is tomorrow night at 5 o'clock. We will be having a jazz trio, and they will be helping us celebrate Christmas. And then at 11 will be our traditional service with our choir taking the lead with their music and their gifts. And so you can't lose. You can't lose. Come to one or the other or come to both. It'll be a great time for all of us. And what a blessing it is to be in each other's company. So, again, I welcome you here. And yes, I did. I made note that you all are sitting in a particularly peculiar but wonderful way, and I want to thank you for that. Thank you. So, take a deep breath. We say it, but more importantly, I want you to know it in the part of yourself that needs to know it the most, that no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. So I would ask Joyce, Pastor Joyce, will you please call us to worship? Gordon would be here except that he hurt his back. So we want to be mindful of him and we want him to get as much rest as possible. Okay.
Listen and join in me later in the call to worship. Jesus answered, I tell you the truth. No one can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to spirit. You should not be surprised at my saying, you must be born again. The wind blows wherever it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from or where it is going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit. There is a transformation that takes place within the warm embrace of love. There is strength in the knowledge that we are refuge, shelter, fortress, and stronghold for each other, against which no army can concede. We are brother, sister, family, folded in the love that knows no bounds. There is strength in trusting that God is love, and we can never be separated from that love. Give birth in us pure hearts, O God, and renew a faithful spirit within us. Give rebirth to us, the joy of your salvation, and restore willing spirits to sustain us.
Please rise as you're comfortably able.
Oh! is for tall prayers. Stand up a little. How many of you have a list for today? Me too. I made my grocery list with Mom at breakfast today. Just set that list aside and let's pray together. We'll start with just a couple breaths of silence. May you give and receive love generously. May this love echo in your heart like the joy of church bells on a clear December day. May each person who comes into your life be greeted as another Christ. May the honor given the babe of Bethlehem be that which you extend to every guest who enters your presence. May the hope of this sacred season settle in your soul. May it be a foundation of courage for you when times of distress occupy your inner land. May the wonder and awe that fills the eyes of children be awakened within you. May it lead you to renewed awareness and appreciation of whatever you too easily take for granted. May the bonds of love for one another be strengthened as you gather around the table of festivity and nourishment. May you keep your eye on the star within you and trust this luminous presence to guide and direct you each day. May you go often to the Bethlehem of your heart and visit the one who offers you peace. May you bring this peace into our world. May it be so. Amen.
Good morning. I'm Liz Curry, president of the Shadow Rock Church Board. And I realize that I'm beginning to sound like a broken record, but your church board has been working extremely hard this year. Last couple of weeks have been especially intense, emotional, challenging, and fulfilling for us. I thought I was doing something wrong. To where my mind's at. And joined up here with other members of the board, Jim Robbins, Monet Davis, Nancy Campbell, Barbara Zaborowski, Micah Torna, Herb Tucker, and Sans Cameron. They're here to convey that this was really a intentional, thought-out decision, much talked about in small circles, in larger circles, very much talked about at our executive council and then at the board meeting. Some of you received this via email. I'm not going to read this whole resolution, but I have hard copies of all of the details that go along with it. And I am going to read verbatim because this is what the board passed at the meeting. But before I do that, I especially want to acknowledge, where did he go? Where's Tim? There's Tim. I especially want to acknowledge Tim Schmaltz. Tim has been, and his wife Linda, have been intimately involved with our sanctuary guests. And Tim actually was the one who first crafted this resolution, and this was especially difficult for him. They have provided incredible amounts of support to Abet and her family, as well as to Sixto. So it's a special acknowledgement of thanks and gratitude to Tim and to Linda. All right, so this is the resolution that was discussed at the Executive Council and then recommended to the board and then approved by your board, the Shadow Rock Board. Shadow Rock UCC has been a catalyst for cutting-edge immigration ministries since June of 2014. Shadow Rock UCC leadership stimulated many of the current ministries provided by many churches and other local groups. Creation and support of these ministries is directly related to Shadow Rock's response to the first request for sanctuary in June 2014. Shadow Rock UCC was the second church congregation in the country to join the new sanctuary movement. Shadow Rock UCC response was in keeping with our mission and values in the Shadow Rock Covenant. However, the evolution of the immigration issue in both larger societal and political contexts necessitates changes to Shadow Rock's participation in these ministries. And we have a five-part resolution. Resolve Part 1. Shadow Rock shall phase out all current immigration ministries, beginning with Hope Station, Phoenix Asylum Hospitality Services. This means we no longer will invest resources, time, and energy in current asylum ministry or Hope Station Phoenix. Resolve Part 2. During this phase-out period, Shadow Rock will maintain its commitment to our current sanctuary guests, Yvette Corral and Sixto Paz and their families, to find their way to freedom and independence and safety and security as long as necessary. Resolve Part 3. Ms. Ayel Perez was our second sanctuary guest from November 2014 through spring of 2015. His case continues through our immigration system of enforcement, courts, and documented status. We will offer interim sanctuary for Ms. Ayel Perez for a limited time so that he may coordinate with the timing of a deportation order appropriate for him and his family. This is being faithful in our walk with our sanctuary guests and our mission of sanctuary ministry. Resolve Part 4. During this phase-out period, Shadow Rock UCC shall temporarily suspend its participation in Family Promise Ministry in order to provide for the privacy and well-being of our sanctuary guest families. And finally, Resolve Part 5. During this phase-out period, Shadow Rock UCC, through the senior minister and member and friends of Shadow Rock feeling called to immigration justice, will offer support for immigration justice ministries locally and nationally. There is a lot of detail that goes with these resolutions, and I have hard copies of them. Feel free to see me after the service, and I'm happy to share them with you. If you have any questions, please contact any of us or Pastor Ken. Thanks for your attention.
Our immigration justice ministries were just one of being and doing cutting edge stuff, which is our brand, which distinguishes us from most other congregations. We have the traditional ministries like other traditional congregations, worship, pastoral care, fellowship, so forth. But we have room in our self-understanding for a cutting-edge ministry, or as I like to call it, a wedge-blade ministry. Organizing ourselves around the unique challenges of wedge-blade ministries and maintaining the traditional ministries at the same time is a unique challenge. It demands from us a depth of community, a depth of interaction and engagement, relationship, and spiritual maturity that enriches everyone who decides to be a part of Shadow Rock United Church of Christ. It is true. People are hungry for belonging. It is true that people are hungry for community, but when belonging and community are linked with vision and purpose, then the experiences of belonging and community give profound meaning to people's lives. That's what we offer. And this was the purpose for engaging in immigration justice ministries. The purpose was not to indulge in another senior minister's pet project. It was senior minister venturing into a wedge blade ministry in hope that such a ministry would be embraced by the entire congregation and such engagement would strengthen our bonds to each other, nurture our spiritual gifts, clarify our calling, and connect us to our neighbor. Such modeling by leadership can sometimes feel like herding cats. We must accept that everybody and every ministry has its story of birth and rebirth. And our immigration justice ministries are no exception. And this is the right time of year for it. Central to the Christmas story is the birth of a child. Historically, we tend to put a nice, warm, fuzzy shine on the story and all the pictures. Mary looks calm and serene. Her clothes are nice and neat. Her hair is in place. She doesn't have that exhausted, tearful, joy-filled look that I saw on Peg's face and a few other mothers in my ministry. And Joseph? Joseph looks non-anxious. Holding his staff, he looks in control. He doesn't look like a real father at all, let alone a new father. A man speaks frantically on the phone. My wife is pregnant and her contractions are only 2 minutes apart. Is this her first child? The doctor inquires. No, you idiot, this is her husband. On most Christmas cards, Jesus is quiet, peaceful, sleeping. And as my wife says, never, ever wake a sleeping baby. And Jesus has a halo around his head. He looks like a Valentine's Day Cupid or one of Michelangelo's cherubs on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. Jesus doesn't look like other babies. He didn't arrive pink and wrinkly with a pointed head. At least that is the romanticized version of the event. I suspect birth is the same everywhere and in every age. It is noisy, messy, painful, traumatic, and bloody, and a wonder beyond words for everyone in the middle of it. Birth is the center of the Christmas story, and I want to focus on the birth event. We have heard of Elf on a Shelf. I want to put on the shelf with the elf the gospel accounts of Matthew and Luke. I do not have to put Mark and John aside because they don't have birth stories anyway. I want to put on a shelf the shepherds and the angels of Luke and the star and the magi of Matthew. These story ingredients speak of the meaning of Jesus' birth, but not to the birth itself. Take away all the wrappings and theological trappings, and what we have is an ordinary birth, which by itself is an extraordinary miracle. Every time there is a birth, every time there is a sunrise, we are assured that God has not given up on us. With every ordinary human birth, we can affirm every life and affirm the deep goodness of life itself. We do this at every funeral. We affirm the uniqueness of every life, and we affirm the unique impact of every other life on our own life. We say there is something holy in the birth, the living, and in the dying of every life. Rabbi Edwin Freeman, Encourage people of faith and conscience to understand birth and death from the perspective of its impact on families. He said the most important event in life for every individual is birth. Can we all say together, duh? He said the most important event in the life of every individual is birth. And this seems so obvious that it feels a little silly to say it. But he says it to set up an important contrast. Rabbi Freeman went on to say that while the most important event in the life of an individual is birth, the most important event in the life of a family is death. The power of this truth is hard to understand until we experience it and hear it articulated for us. When someone in our family dies, all relationships are up for grabs. People who were connected can separate, and those who were cut off from each other can come back together. The rigidity of all the family relationships loosen up and have the potential to be new again. And this is an example of rebirth for the family. We get it that birth is a miracle. Every life a gift, and every death a loss, and every loss a kind of death. Knowing this in our heart and our mind makes us wise. But there's more. Within every death are the seeds of rebirth. The title of the message could have been Birth, Death, and Rebirth. In fact, Karen made a comment indicating that the missing link of death was conspicuous and perhaps indicative of our middle-class privileged place to deny death. Am I putting words in your mouth? A little bit? Not my, okay. It helps the sermon to do that. It's just, okay. I usually do it with Peg, so it's... Okay. I mention it now to give death its due. However, I want to be careful. I do not see birth, life, death, and rebirth as opposing forces or a duel between dualities. I see them as the same up and down continuous wave of life. They are related in the same way that when we were 5 years old and 10 years later we were 15 years old, we were the same person and not the same person at the same time. And so it is with birth and rebirth, with death in between. There is that saying about the different stages of our relationship with Santa Claus. We go from believing to being to finally in our later years to looking like Santa Claus. We are always the same person, just being reborn into different self-understanding. This happens to us as individuals, as families, as a church family, as a nation, and most profoundly, as a species. When we look deeper into the Christmas story, we see that it is more than a birth story. The wisdom of the first believers saw it as a story of birth and death and rebirth. In a piece of the letter to the church people in Philippi, one of the earliest choir anthems is quoted. Let each of you look not to your own interests, but to the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus. And here's the mindset that he's talking about, that the choir was talking about. Who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but instead emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient, that is, listened to the way life is, so he could not act otherwise than the way of love. Act obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Hear the transformation of birth, loss, death, and rebirth, and the actions of God for the sake of love. Birth and rebirth is at the center of our covenant. We are always in the flux of birth and rebirth as we perceive and respond to God's newest thrust in the midst of history. Birth and rebirth, remember, it's messy, it's painful, it's bloody, traumatic, exhausting, and wonderful beyond words. Birth is hard work. Rebirth is hard labor. And death in between is hard as well, but it is where the seeds of rebirth are planted. This is where we are with our immigration justice ministries. Our congregation gave birth to some great things. We gave birth to hope for Marco, Misiel, Ishmael, Jose, Jesus, Sixto, and Yvette, and all their families. We gave birth to years of family togetherness that the government would have otherwise denied them. We were the first congregation in the valley to restore hope for asylum seekers when several governments and violent gangs tried to steal their hope. We gave rebirth to their hope. We gave rebirth that America is a great nation, and our greatness lies in our strength to share our blessings and to be kind and to be hospitable. The changing landscape of immigration internally for us at Shadow Rock and the changing landscape of immigration in society demands that some things change and die. Some grieve, and some will be glad. Regardless, in the change and death of our current immigration ministries are the seeds for the rebirth of new wedge blade ministries. We've learned a great deal these last 4.5 years. It is exciting to think that God is always doing a new thing. The Lamb that sits upon the throne at the end of time, behold, make all things new. And if you're crying, the Lamb wipes away every tear. And if you're hurt, take the leaves of healing from the river of life and heal you. We've learned a great deal. And this is one of the truths of Christmas, is that God is always doing a new thing, and we get to be a part of it. The birth of Jesus is one of God's thrusts in the midst of history for those who are sensitive and perceptive enough to see it. However, what is most exciting for me is watching you pray, watching you study, watching you discern God's newest thrust in history for today, and watching you faithfully be the sensitive and responsive part of human society. Otherwise, you will be known as the people of God, as Shadow Rock United Church of Christ. And so, Merry Christmas, and hang on, because the new year is coming. Amen. Amaya, please share your gift with us.
White Christmas.
Thank you, Amaya. So this is the time in our service where we lift up the celebrations of our lives, and our celebrations can be a birthday, it can be an anniversary, it can be perhaps you were surprised by grace this past week. So I want to start out, first of all, by lifting up that I don't know how many hours that Jean and Roy and Greg spent on getting the rocket brakes put on so that, how many hours was it? 16. 16 hours, times three to do that. And so it's ready for this morning, and then it'll be ready for Christmas Eve. And so there are lots and lots and lots of volunteer giving of people's selves to the work of this church that happens all the time behind the scenes. And that's just one example. And of course, by lifting up one example, I'm leaving out all the others. Right, Bill? And it's no intent, no slight is intended, but thank you for that. Then the other thing is, yes, the other thing I celebrate are the newlyweds here this morning. Okay. Okay. And then I celebrate that next Sunday we will be blessed with the family, the Morrison family, and a baptism. We look forward to that. Thank you so much for that. All right. Now, Gene, you have.
I'm celebrating a new beginning and an ending. For the first time in my entire life, not only learned how to fix brakes, thank you, Greg, thank you, Roy, but I also had my first manicure to get the grease and the grime and the brake dust and all the stuff that happened. And if anybody would like to see themselves, because I also have my nails buffed, I have a see yourself shine in my nails for the first time in my entire life. So that's a new beginning. The ending is, I want to thank all of you that have ridden with me on the rocket. Passing that mantle to Stephanie. Stephanie, would you please stand up? She'll be driving the rocket on the fourth Sundays from now on.
Thank you, Stephanie. All
right. And it gave me an opportunity to meet really wonderful people. And many of you are here today, and many of those people that have driven are no longer with us. But it's been a lot of fun. And I'll continue to do things like solstice, summer and winter. And I will be driving at 5 o'clock tomorrow. So if any of you want one last ride with me, officially, I'll be driving the 5 o'clock service. But thank you. And if you would like me to drive really fast, I'll put it in street mode instead of turf mode, and we can zip right along. Right, Tim? Tim got to ride in street mode today.
All right.
Fast, huh, Tim?
All right.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Many of you know that I work at Starbucks, and I'm often talking about the wonderful people who work there, and that the people, who obviously are much younger than I am, give me great hope for our future. And I'm excited to introduce Abby, who came today and is leaving here to work an 8-hour shift and then go to a partner party. And she is a wonderful example of one of the neat young people who works at Starbucks. So I'm excited that she's here.
Oh, thank you. Welcome. Welcome. And who are you? The president of the board. Okay.
I'm Liz Curry, president of the board.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. All right. Sybil.
I'm Sybil Eppinger, and I am thrilled today to have one of my daughters, Priscilla, here with me for Christmas. Priscilla lives in Atlanta, and she's here for a week, and I'm blessed.
Amen. Thank you. You're welcome.
Several weeks ago, my wife Susan announced that my daughter Haley was not going to be with us for Thanksgiving and possibly not at Christmas. But the Navy got its act together, and Haley's sitting here with me today.
Thank you.
She will be here for Christmas before she's stationed for 3 years in Sicily.
Wow. Haley, welcome, and thank you for your service.
Thank you.
All right. Wonderful. Moving this way. Who has a mic? Mickey.
Oh, I do. Mickey Tucker. Herb and I are happy to say that Jesse will be home for Christmas, and there might be a sighting at 11 tomorrow.
Wonderful.
We're told.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ashley. I want to say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, guys.
Thank you.
And this toast is a lot to me. I love it, and I like Ken. And this is a good show this morning, so I'm going to have Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, and I will definitely come next time, maybe.
Yeah, all right. Thank you, Ashley. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Ashley.
Good morning. I had this morning, while I was still at home drinking coffee, my phone pinged, and it was our first Our Whole Lives registration for the February training. So, woohoo! You can be the second one. You can be number two. So, talk to me at Coffee Chat if you want to be an OWL facilitator.
Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. Linda.
Good morning. Linda Johnson. Three things. Something my husband hates to hear. Three things. Five and a half weeks ago, I cracked my toe, I kicked a cooler, and I can actually get into matching shoes today, which is good. Yesterday, our son Chris, had a moment of grace. So I would like to celebrate the person that did the pay it forward and paid for his meal at the drive-thru, and it totally shocked him. He said, why would that happen? Why would somebody do that? I said, that's Christmas, son. And thirdly, what's that other thing coming up? Yeah. On the 25th, I have a birthday, 69. I'm going to be 69 for the rest of my life. I don't want to do 70.
Yes, happy birthday. Wonderful. And as we said, there's a different there's a homecoming, and there's some homecoming with the Hilliard children in the back. So, hey, guys, welcome. And
hey.
And we know, look. Vaughn, we know that your sister is the smarter one, but you're lifted up all the time on MSNBC. Okay, I just want to put that. Okay, we're going to. Okay. Who has a mic? Oh, Kathy.
Today, I'd like to celebrate my sister, who has come from Wisconsin to be with us and to participate musically with us on Christmas Eve, so I'm really happy that she's here.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Mike Catorno. I've got a celebration and a moment of grace that are related. I want to lift up that once again, Shadow Rock supported the Stepping Stone Foundation Christmas Angel program beautifully, magnificently, and thank you. Thank you all for that. Part of the program is once in a while we identify a family within the program, the Christmas Angel program, that we call TLC, Tender Loving Care is Needed. Generally a family that really has next to nothing, if not nothing. We had one this year, and when word got out, Ibeth, our wonderful sanctuary guest, offered up what she had put in storage when she came into sanctuary here regarding her furniture. And this family needed furniture, something to sit on, beds, clothing. And she stepped up. And she offered what she can, which was very, very generous to this loving family. Everything that she's been through, and yet she still feels the love to pay it forward. I want to thank her and lift her up.
Amen. Thank you for that.
I'm Forrest, and I'd like to celebrate Kathy's sister. she's with us from Atlanta, and we've been able to, she came in on last Wednesday, and I don't know how she did it, but she made it through a rehearsal after being on the plane forever and changing time zones. And she's wonderful. You don't want to miss her tomorrow night. And also, tomorrow night will be our very own Bill, who will be playing with the choir. So it will be, while it will be the usual gang here, and we love us, it will be with some very, very, very nice enhancements. So it's going to be a really nice Christmas Eve. Okay, thank you.
Amen to that. Thank you. Sharon.
Sharon Ray. I don't know about the rest of you, but I feel like I'm one of those pebbles that drops into a stream. And I'm sure you feel this way, too. These are my Shadow Rock babies. Not just Vaughn, but Dakota and Amaya. I want my babies to stand up. Dakota, Amaya, Vaughn, Tara, Duncan, Riley, if you're one of my babies, stand up.
What? Stand up.
Duncan. I love it when my babies come back.
Amen. Thank you so much. Wonderful. Yes.
Good morning. My name is Susan, and I don't know if you know that you have an angel among you. Betty, who invited me here to 3 weeks ago, but talk about a graceful fall on the golf course due to my lack of keeping my dog under control. So please pray for Betty. And she got up gracefully and gave me a hug and said, don't you worry about it. You're worrying about it is making me feel bad. So God bless you, Betty. Thank you.
Amen. All right. Great.
All right, because Sharon calls us out here, and Ken calls us out here, there's a reason we come back, and I just want to make that very clear. We come back because we love you guys. I haven't had a chance to talk to Maya and Dakota and everybody as to why they come back, but there's a reason that you all instilled in us, and I could give you all a long-winded speech from Gene to everybody that messages and sends kind messages over Facebook and email. I've been gone for more than 6 years now from Phoenix, and time starts to go by quickly. But there's the one family here that is always there for you, and it's this church. And I sent a friend of mine a photo of the church on a little run. I ran into Beth Bruce on my run yesterday, but I always come up, and I always stop and look at this church on my run for a reason. And it's been with me there every step of my life, and I appreciate you guys, and I know that's a sentiment that we all share. And for as long as I live, I'll be coming back to this place. So thank you guys very much.
Thank you, Ron.
All right, this is Roy Zebrowski. I want to thank and appreciate the congregation. You mentioned it when we started, but thank you all for moving to the center. I can hear a difference in the back of the room. I don't know what it sounds like in the choir, but this place sounds better. When we have more energy in the center, it just sounds a lot better. So thank you so much. The second thing I want to celebrate is I'd like to celebrate our office staff, every single one of them. I wish them a very deep felt Merry Christmas to you all. Thank you for everything. Heidi and Lois have just been knocking themselves out this last 2 months. Unfortunately, I don't know where, I think Lois is attending to the doors, maybe. I don't know. Is she here right now? Oh, okay. Heidi, of course, will be here tomorrow night. But thank you all so much for making Shadow Rock run. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. Yeah, we have received a lot of gifts, especially gifts of food and at the office, and we're very grateful for that. And in fact, we have one that had a little name tag, you know, to and from, and I think it was from Susan. And it said, to our great staff and Pastor Ken.
Okay. The spirit moved me.
Oh, my goodness.
It was hilarious. Let's sing our celebration song.
Looking down at Christmas, love, oh, lovely love.
receive this invitation to give. As an accepted, reconciled, and empowered people, let us give our offering for the work of ministry in this place and beyond.
They came. This is the all come. You can come too. Be careful of the poinsettias. We'll be standing all around them. And those of you who are not coming up to sing, we have sung this every year that I have been here because it's probably my favorite Christmas song. And this year, Ken requested it, so that was very nice. So y'all come up, and if you're in the pews, sing with us. I'm sure you know it.
That was fun. Please join me and stand if you're able. The dedication of ourselves and offerings. May the love underlying the deep structures of all life give birth to compassion for all people, to all people. Spirit of birth and rebirth, stir within us a consciousness of our spiritual bond that shares pains, heals hurts, and nurtures hopes. These are the times.
We are the people.
All of creation is blessed.
May we love all and serve all.
May God be with you.
And also with you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.